It's Vlogmas day 9! I just posted a picture of myself like this with like a double hat thing on the noggin. I'm so cold, I just walked the dog. So I'm freezing. And it's a rockin' Friday night in my world and I got like no plans. So I don't really have anything exciting to talk about. So on Instagram I had asked if anyone could send me some questions because I've got nothing interesting to talk about today. I don't know. This is why I don't like vlog on the regular, y'all, because I'm boring. However, I did get some happy mail from Adriana Piper. I will leave her link below. I have ordered many things from Rebecca in the past, and she is a really good internet friend, so check out her stuff. But I actually ordered this, I can't remember if it was Black Friday or if it was Cyber Monday, but I ordered it then. But anyway, let me show you what I got and then I'll get into some of the questions that you guys have been asking me on Instagram. Hold on a second. Okay, so here is what I got from Adriana Piper. This was a cute little sampler. This is a nice little sampler I got too. And then she always includes like little extras as well. So I got these. She knows I love functional things, so I think that's why she sent these guys. And then these little cute little crock pots, which are kind of cute. And then these are the three sheets that I ordered. So I ordered some like little floppy disks, which I thought were really cute. I could use these for like work or home because I'm like constantly like backing up files and stuff. Got these little bathtubs because I thought it would be kind of nice to put these in when I like take the dog to the groomer and stuff. I'm not a bath fan. I know that's kind of weird, but I hate baths for myself. I feel like I'm just like soaking in my filth. I don't know. Even if I'm clean, I don't like a bath personally. It's just not my thing. And then the last sheet I got was this. And these are these cute little ones on the very top. They say play date, and there's just like some random ones. Normally you would think someone with kids would want these, but the reason I want them is because in the summertime, now that I am closer, I'm sure I'm gonna be doing some stuff with my nephew Jackson, which you actually saw in yesterday's vlog. So yeah, I wanted to get some of these because I thought they'd be really cute, or if I have like, you know, something at the park or whatever. I don't know. But yeah, so these, like these ones, hold on, I can't even talk. These ones were all like little freebies, which was kind of cute. And then she always puts the little card in there. And then, let's see here. She wrote me a little note saying, "Hey girl." So funny. So I'm gonna grab my phone and then we'll answer some questions. I'm pretty sure I only got like one or two questions because I just posted it like a second ago. Oh, let's see here. All right, let's go somewhere else and answer some questions. Dun, 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 dun. Ugh. I guess not, because somebody's at the front door. Hold on, I'm back. False alarm, wrong place. Okay. So, let's go answer the questions. This is like my corner. It's like the corner questions vlog. So there's a couple of questions. Let me get to the first one. Coffee or tea? Tea. I drink, I think it's Twinings or Twinings English breakfast tea. That's what I get. I think I showed that in, was it the first vlog? Yeah, I got like a whole bunch of it from Amazon, so that was really good. But yeah, I hate coffee. And I know I'm like the only planner girl out there maybe that doesn't like coffee, but I gotta tell you, that stuff, like, not to get like too disgusting, but that stuff goes like right through me. And it just, it's not good. I actually don't mind the way it tastes at all. It's just, it doesn't do well for my body, if that makes any sense. So yeah, so tea is for me. Tea is for me. The next question, have you always been a planner or is this new for you? Actually, I think I addressed this in one of my Q&As before, but I've always kind of been a planner. Back in the day, I actually used to get these like little inserts from Franklin Covey, which I don't even think is around anymore. And I had like a leather, I don't even know if it was real leather, it was probably like a faux leather, like agenda thing that had like a zip around it. So I've always been kind of a paper planner, but then I kind of got out of that once like iPhones were introduced and I had like the iCal and everything. But even then I would still miss stuff because I know, like, in the first couple of versions of the iPhone, you couldn't, like, alert yourself about things and whatever. So I was still missing stuff, which is why I started paper planning again. And also the reason I got into paper planning, well, one of the reasons is that I've been a huge fan of Jennifer Ross from Pretty Neat Living. I'll put her information below in this video. I started watching her when she had, I think, like, less than 1,000 subscribers, maybe. So it was, like, obviously a long time ago because she has quite a following now. And I started watching her on her, like, organized, like, Jen channel. Now it's all, like, all of her channels. I think she had, like, 3, maybe 4 channels total. Now they're all consolidated into one. So it's just, like, her brand is her versus, like, all these other channels, you know? So anyway, it makes more sense. But I loved her organization videos, and I also liked her vlogs. I know she doesn't vlog anymore, but she is on Snapchat every once in a while. But I can totally understand, like, she's a new mom and she doesn't want to share that part, or she wants to, you know, like, control what she shares, and I totally understand that. But she did a bunch of planning videos a while back showcasing Erin Condren stuff. I was like, oh, maybe I should check this place out. And then I, like, would go online and peruse, but I never, like, signed up, or, you know, I didn't, like, use the, like, referral code or anything. And I was just, like, looking and looking, and I'm like, I don't know. And then, like, the next year came, and I'm like, well, maybe I should do it. And so I looked and looked and looked, and then I never did it. And then I was like, the next year happened, and I was like, okay, I need to just do this. And it was right before, I remember it was right before the launch of, like, the new planners. So it was, like, the summertime that I was looking. Yeah, and then, you know, signed up for my $10 off coupon code, and the rest is history, because I'm pretty sure I've already placed, like, 20 Erin Condren orders, which is, like, insane. It's just, it's insane, you guys. It's insane. So to answer the question, yes, I have always been a planner. I've always been, like, very goal-oriented. I've always been someone that likes to write things down, and, like, you know, I'll write things down on my daily, like, to-do list just to check them off, because it's just, like, who I am. So yeah, I've always definitely been a planner and someone that likes paper to pen. I've always been that person. Technology is great, but only if it works for you. And some things work well for me in technology, and other things do not work well for me in technology. So, you know, you gotta figure out what works for you. Ooh, this, oh my gosh, these are difficult questions. Okay, it's a really short question. One word for 2017. Oh gosh, if I can only pick one word for 2017. Oh man. I'm gonna have to come up with something, like, really good. I've got the word. The word is gonna be progress. 2017, if I have to pick a word for 2017, it's gonna be progress. Because I feel like it's a hopeful word, and it's also a word that keeps us moving forward. And I'm all about progress. I'm all about moving forward. I'm all about learning something new. That's what this channel is about. That's what I'm all about as an individual. That's what my personal life is about and my professional life is about. So yeah, progress. I think progress is a good word. I mean, what do you guys think? If you guys have a word for 2017, post them in the comments below. I would love to know what your word for 2017 would be. That's a really good question. I also have, do I have any resolutions for 2017? Resolutions, I don't like the word. Sorry, just don't like it. I like to use the word goals instead, because I feel like that's easier for someone to achieve. A resolution is, I'm doing this wrong, but a goal is, I'm moving forward. So you're not, like, it's, like, more of, like, a negative connotation, I feel like, in society, and then also, like, in my own brain. But that's just the way that I think. I mean, if you don't think that, that's totally fine. But as for resolutions or goals of 2017, I'm actually gonna be filming, like, a whole video on that, and that'll be up either at the very tail end of the early part of January, or, like, the tail end of December. I haven't fully decided yet. Sorry, I keep moving the camera around because, like, my arms are so sore. I'm gonna be sharing some things. I'm gonna be doing a whole video on it. I have some categories that I want to talk about. So if there's certain things that you guys want to know about in, like, my goals for 2017, make sure to post them below, and I'll answer those in that video, because I haven't filmed it yet, but I probably will be filming it. Actually, I might be filming it this weekend or next. I don't know. But I want to talk about career. I want to talk about personal, like, life, you know, just, like, my own, like, social life. And then I also want to talk about, like, YouTube and this channel. So I think those are the three things I'm going to hit on in my, like, goals video for 2017. But if there's anything else that you guys want me to talk about, let me know and I'll consider it. All right, so I'm going to answer this one last question, because I feel like I'm just, like, going on and on and on. All right, so I've got another question here from Planning with Gabriella, or Gabriella, Gabriella probably. Let me know if I'm wrong. Planning with Gabriella says, if you could live anywhere in the world, where would you live? Well, Planning with Gabriella, that is a good question. So recently, okay, I've got like two parts to this answer. I feel like, oh, I would love to live in Wilmington, North Carolina. I lived there before. It is such a beautiful town. The people are so nice. The weather is fantastic, minus the hurricanes. But the ocean's right there. It's a great space. The housing is beautiful. The weather is beautiful. The people are beautiful. Like, I don't know, I just love it. I love East Coast. West Coast isn't really my jam long term. Like, if I were to live there for a year or something, like, I wouldn't really care. But I've been out to, like, the West Coast a lot in my life, and I just never felt comfortable even on like vacation, you know what I mean? So I don't know, it's just not me, but I am definitely an East Coast person. I actually went to Boston this past summer and had a great time. Obviously I know that's like Northeast, that's a little bit different, but even like all my trips to Florida, my parents live in Florida now, so I don't know. I mean, I just love the East Coast. I think it is such a great place. I think it's a little bit more like relaxed and chill, which I really like, because I feel like in the Midwest, things are kind of stereotyped a little bit, but me being from like Minneapolis, I'm very much like go, go, go all the time. And when I go to the East Coast, I feel like I kind of level out a little bit. Like even when I lived there, it took me a really long time to just chill out because I was so used to like everyone being so fast and so fast, but they weren't fast there. Like, I remember going to the bank repeatedly because this is like, I mean, they had drive-up ATMs, but you know, I'd always just go inside. I remember them like always wanting to get to know me and like asking a lot of questions and like just taking a really long time, and I would just get so frustrated. I mean, I wouldn't like go off on them or anything, but it was just like, I was just so in this other mindset of like, go, 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 like get the next person done, you know? But that's just the lifestyle there. So I feel like that's good for me to just like chill out, not worry so much about the next 5 minutes and just like be there and be present. And that was like really difficult for me when I lived there. But once I was there, I loved it. The reason I left is because of the housing situation. My roommate was leaving and I didn't really have anybody else to room with, and this was back when I was like not in a good financial space. I mean, obviously if you watch my financial video, you'll know about me. So then I ended up coming back to Minnesota and staying with my parents for a little while until I got my act together, and yeah, then the rest is history. So if I could pick somewhere in the US, that is where I would live. Wilmington, North Carolina, look it up on the map, it's amazing. And then if I could live anywhere in the world, so I've recently been thinking about this a lot lately, because I mean, I haven't traveled a lot. I mean, I've traveled in the US, but I haven't traveled like internationally a lot. I've been to like Mexico, I've been to Cancun and like Tijuana, I don't know. I mean, I've been to Cancun, what was it, twice? Yeah, twice. Once when I was a kid, and then like once when I was like 19? I think it was 19. Yeah, I was 19, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, so I don't know where I would like live internationally, just because I haven't like experienced it. I have to say that a lot of my, like, not to get political, y'all, but like a lot of my views really align with Canada, like just very open and very accepting and things like that. So I don't know, I mean, it would still be cold because, I mean, I'm in Minnesota, so I understand the coldness factor because, you know, you're more north. And I lived in Fargo before, which is, you know, I like to say basically Canada, but it is actually very far away from Canada, but it's closer. But yeah, I don't know, maybe Canada. I mean, I don't know enough about other countries, like enough about the economics and stuff. I mean, I know some of the economic stuff about Canada because when I worked for the Granite Company, we actually sold to Canada vendors, so I knew a lot about some of the logistics and some of the other stuff that we had to figure out because we dealt with Canadian vendors that I had no idea about, and I'm, you know, learning more about them. So I don't know, maybe I would say Canada, eh? And I feel like most Canadians that I've ever met are like pretty chill as well, which is kind of nice. I think that's the theme of this video. Like, Emily, you just need to chill out. You just need to chill out. Okay, so I think that is all I am going to answer for today because now I'm into the 15-minute mark, which probably won't be 15 minutes for you because I'm going to edit the snot out of this thing. But if you guys keep posting comments that I haven't gotten to on my Instagram, I might use them later for another, like, vlog Q&A because, let's face it, my life is kind of boring. But I'm glad that you guys are enjoying the Vlogmas situation, and I hope you didn't mind that I just did, like, this one take kind of a thing today with my crazy double hat situation because I'm still kind of cold even though I got in like 20 minutes ago. That's what happens when you live in Minnesota and it's like 4 degrees outside. You coming over here? You gonna say hello to the video? All right, well, I'm gonna get going. Doyle is here as well. He wanted to say hello to you guys. I know you guys haven't seen him in a couple of days. I feel like it's been a couple of days. You always get the little furs right on your snout. Right on this snout. Right on this snout. Why are you letting me do this to your face? He's weird. He just wants tummy rubs. That's what he wants. Tummy rubs. Tummy rubs. All right, well, I'm gonna get going. I wanna get this footage edited and uploaded and scheduled for you guys. Tomorrow, I actually have really fun things planned. I might do some filming in the morning, but I am going to a planner meetup, which is gonna be exciting. So hopefully I can vlog a little bit there. We are gonna be going to the Mall of America in Bloomington, Minnesota. We're going to a place that I've never been. It's called Crave. It's a place, you know, like a food place. So that'll be fun. I'm not sure who's all coming, but I'm excited nonetheless, even if I don't actually know anybody. That's okay, because then you get to know people. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, I hope you guys are having a better Rockin' Friday night than I am. But by the time you see this, it'll be Saturday night. So hope you guys are having a good Saturday night. And I will see you all in the next vlog. Bye, guys. Bye, guys.